a day in the life of the Hudson River. The annual event has one goal each year: connect young people to nature through the river.
I'm hoping that I'm going to catch a catfish.
Commissioner Sagos joined DEC experts at one of today's events in Albany, assisting students as they became scientists for a day, collecting and analyzing data from the field through hands-on exploration of the Hudson River estuary.
Nothing beats getting out into the field to truly understand a problem or to appreciate a resource. That's why this day in the life of the Hudson is so important for us as an agency. We get to connect all these students up and down the river, all these communities up and down the river, with this great resource and let them get their hands wet. I mean, I remember when I was a kid and I got to see tadpoles for the first time. I don't remember anything else about that year, but I remember the tadpoles in this little pond. I'm hoping that something that happens today with these kids that have come down to the river, connect with the resource, understand what we're trying to do to protect it, and ultimately make them conservationists.
Now in its 20th year, the Day in the Life event draws an estimated 5,000 students statewide, from New York City to Troy, up and down the river at more than 100 locations.
So now, because we have all of these dozens of sites along the river, we're able to see in a given day the distribution, how the different species occur along the river, and also the change over time.
Happening on the same day, DEC made a big announcement: $1.4 million in grants for 23 projects to help communities along the Hudson River estuary improve water quality and boost environmental education and stewardship.
Governor Hochul did an incredible job this year increasing the size of the Environmental Protection Fund, and we're using those resources right now to dedicate dollars to projects which ultimately improve the health of this river.
All signs pointing to an even brighter future for those watershed communities through investments, education, and a little help from the youngest environmental stewards among us.